Svarpilen up, y'all.
What is up, ladies and gentlemen? I am Kaethorin of Kaethorin Games, and here we are to do today's dailies. We got to do a daily ride on a husqvarna, a sport bike, and a Ninja H2R. Or H2. Whichever one you prefer. But I'm going to be on the DB8 Oranaro for race one. Yep, race one, come on. Look out of here, Panigale ass. Really? Really, Panigale ass? Motherfucker. This bike has a lot of power. And I got a KTM RC8, which is, I believe, an 1190cc V-twin. That I need to beat. And it seems like that's about to happen. Starting to pull ahead, it's turn. Oh god, he's right in my left ear. Hell yeah. This is gonna be a race. Yep. Race like no tomorrow. Look at this guy. He's right on my butt. Right up my ass. Exactly what I'm expecting. This is exactly what I want in a race. Someone right up my ass. That three-quarter brake is actually pretty damn good. I think I slowed down a bit earlier than I needed to, but whatever. Yeah. That's right, they're just getting further and further behind now. They're trying to get these lines perfect while I'm just trying to take corners quick, which is what gets them. Well, basically, the ideal trajectory is their path. So if you can cut out sections of the path where they'll be going slower anyways, by going a tiny bit quicker and entering a bit earlier, like that. Yeah, exactly like that. That's how you pull ahead. And there is 3 seconds. That's actually a pretty good, decent space. Depending on the track, it will depend on if I have it on easy or medium from now on, I think. Miami is definitely a track that will be best on easy versus people. Because it's a tighter, more 90 degree base track. Most corners are around 90 degrees. Float the front wheel up in the air like a pro. Come around this corner and be out. That was a horrible wheelie coming out of the corner, but we are good. We're gonna be going as fast as possible at this point. This track doesn't allow for you to reach top speed on most bikes that are in the super bike category, per se. The DB8 Oranaro is a sport bike, but since it's above 1,000 cc's, you technically classify it as a super bike rather than a super sport. But that's fine. Because just because it's kind of classified as a super bike doesn't mean that it's not a sport bike. In fact, actually, it just makes it even more of a sport bike. Because these are the ones that take more skill to ride, take more challenging throttle control, take more challenging brake control. Because these things have brakes that, if you lock them up, it will not be your friend. But if you lock them up in a straight line, I was hoping that there would be at least a little bit of a wobble so you could see. If you lock them up in a straight line, there, not that hard to get away from. No! I'm not doing it that way. I need the wheel up in the air when I finish, but not fall and have it flying across, have the bike flying across the line. Well, I guess it's now time to do the Husqvarna race. The Husqvarna race is actually on a pretty decent bike. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is the 401 Svarpilen by Husqvarna for this race. I was debating doing an SM race, and then I was like, you know what, nah, let's do a naked race. This is gonna be nice and fun. Let's go. I have a feeling that, wow. This bike is just damn quick off the line. That's a good thing, I like that. I like a quick bike off the line. Quick bike off the line means earlier lead for me. As you can see, every time that I tap the brakes, the RPMs actually can go up, which is pretty good. It helps doing wheelies, and I like doing wheelies. And that happens because I am tapping the brakes and have joint brakes on, so the rear wheel technically is locking up as well as the front wheel. Not fully locking, there's no skid. Aww, set face. This bike just doesn't have the power in 5th and 6th gear to do wheelies. 4th gear it tries. 3rd gear it'll come up, but I feel that 1st, 2nd will be your best friend if you're trying to do wheelies on this Svarpilen. Ooh. Now, if I remember correctly, Husqvarna is a Swedish company. Yeah. Even if they aren't, whatever company or country is responsible for these bikes is responsible for some pretty damn cool bikes being on the road. Ooh, that was a little one for 5th gear. I probably could have gotten away with a medium AI for this race. I guess it actually more depends on what bike I'm on versus the rest, overall. But that's hard to know and adjust without actually having the, prior knowledge of who I'm going to be facing on the track. This thing actually will, like... Ooh, 4th gear? Yeah, 5th gear just doesn't have the power for it. And I imagine, actually, it's nothing to do with gearing, because all that I have set up is a gearing that'll actually make the wind out of the gears a bit longer. That's about it. So, and it's not much longer overall because I'm not there's no power in 5th gear to do wheelies, at least the way that I do them. But the gearing that I chose is based off of the final ratio for naked bikes. The naked bike final ratio is a 5 instead of a 4. Itchy leg. But yeah, it being a 5 instead of a 4 just means that I have a bit, like, minorly less torque overall. Because if I didn't have the same amount of torque as originally, I don't think I would have, or about the same amount of torque as originally going through the gears. I don't think I would have actually had the ability to have done a wheelie coming out of that corner like that. But there is something that I could try right now. Yeah, it takes a lot of effort, and you gotta endo to wheelie that thing. Now, that's actually not my favorite way to do wheelies, and Jesus, why am I 21 seconds ahead? What the hell are these guys riding that puts me that far ahead? There is no reason. You guys are on easy AI, come on now. I'm not that good. I mean, you guys saw. I was only like 6 seconds ahead by the end of the race of whoever was in second place from me. That's not a... I mean, that's 3 seconds a lap, but still. That's not like... This is lap two, and I'm like... I'm basically going up 12 seconds a lap on these people to 13 seconds a lap on these people. That's ridiculous. Have I had traction control? No, I should have turned it off. I feel like I did. Have I had traction control on the whole time, I ask myself? And I answer my own question with a... Fuck no, homie! Wheelies for the finish. That actually took a lot more focus to do than I thought it would have to do that wheelie. But now it's on to the dreaded H2R race, and I'm sure you guys are going to enjoy that one. I'm definitely going to have to step the H2R race down to... Actually, you know what? Oh, wow, I was facing SATA 3.5s, a W800. I figured that was there. I saw that. The P62 is actually a pretty decent bike. I'm kind of disappointed that the Tuono didn't do better. I feel like the Tuono should have came up close to where the SATA did. Hmm. Take the H2R to the track, they said. It'd be fun, they said. Alright, we got the Kawasaki Ninja H2R. Because I don't own the regular H2, and I don't ever want to own the regular H2 in this game, because guess what? I don't want that bike. Come on, yeah. Fuck out of here with this bullshit, bros. God, that was a wide corner. You ain't taking first from me. I ain't giving it up. So, curiosity's sake, if you can, leave down in the comments below how you're doing, what you guys would like to see me talk about. And if you've made it this far, drop a goddamn like below, because that means a shit ton to me and keeps these videos a-coming. I'd like to shoot for more likes. Hey, buddy, get back here. Yeah, damn straight you're gonna get back here and then fall in line right behind me. See, the superbike races, I'm only like a half a second ahead on easy, which is really nice. I'm actually being challenged here and needing to do better and better. Look at that throttle control on the H2R through a corner. It's becoming easier and easier for me to control this bike. I'm not a big fan of it with all of its power because... Like, I just tapped back a tiny bit on the joystick there. And that's what happened. And if you tap a little bit forward on the joystick while braking, you end up getting an endo. Legitimately, watch. Like, the front wheel wants to dip so bad. And I don't blame it. It's gotta stop a bike that is moving basically 300 and something miles an hour by the end of its top speed. I feel like this thing gets up to like 300. It's like, I think it's like almost 400 kilometers an hour. I haven't actually double-checked the top speed of the Kawasaki Ninja ZX-6R because there's actually no place where it can be tested. At least inside of this game. I don't have enough space to do it. Because most of the drag races finish after about a mile. And it takes longer than a mile to hit the top speed of sixth gear. I'm 7 seconds ahead now, jeez. 7 seconds ahead on the last lap. I guess I could probably get away with a bit more of a challenging AI. I don't know. You guys let me know in the comments below what you would like to see. Would you like to see me face something harder than easy next daily challenges? That's your goal. Those comments, I'm gonna say, how you doing? And point out if you'd like to see me bump up to medium or drop back down to very easy so there can be a bit more of a conversation had, or stay at easy so we can have conversation here, conversation there, while I book around the track and focus occasionally on difficult corners for me and the bike. And the other goal of, the other quest for you guys today is to drop a like on this video. Share it. Pass it on to everyone you know. Let them see this. Get this video seen, because my goal is to hit 1,000 subs by summertime. So let's do this. Let's do this. If I don't make it to 1,000 subs by summertime, whatever. But I'd like to make it there, so let's make this a goal. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.